So this is my Tour de France GC predictions. Now, first of all, we're just gonna go through the key stages. There's not many of them, in my opinion. And then we're gonna go through the contenders, how they've done so far, and why I think each of them is gonna do what they're gonna do in the Tour. So first of all, we'll go on to some of the stages. Now, this is a summit finish. So the first thing to note is there's 60 kilometers of time trialing, so that's pretty important. That means if you can't time trial, you can lose a lot of time, like Nidoman, etc. So this is, yeah, like stage 17, I think it is. Col de Portet, decently hard, like 16.4K at 9%. That's decent. With a couple climbs before, there could be some splits up here, up to 2,200. We might see something happen. I find it hard to get excited about the Tour because it's just so boring most of the stages. This thing, literally nothing will happen. Roglic will just win a bunch sprint. 20K at 5.5%. I don't know why they put these stages in. Nothing's going to happen, but that is a summit finish, so you might as well just get excited about that. And then obviously this one, stage 18 as well, comes after the Col de Portet stage, so could be maybe exciting. But Col de Tourmalet is hard, 17K at 7.4, and Luzard d'Isère hasn't been used for a fair few years now. 13K at 7.5%, that's decent. Again, I can't see a crazy amount happening. So I think the main thing that's going to be decisive really is just the time trials and then like making sure they don't lose. Obviously, like the first couple stages are a bit technical, finishes on the Mur de Bretagne, etc. So I picked out some of the favorites, I guess, just based on, you know, their form so far. So first is Miguel Angel Lopez, one Mont Ventoux, Denis Velez Challenge, sixth at the Dauphiné, one Andalusia, hasn't really done much else. Last year, he finished sixth in the Tour. To be honest, the most important thing to remember about this man is that he finished 45th on the last ATT, which finished an upper climb. He can't time trial. He's not going to do well. So cheerio, lad. He's not going to be getting very good at all. Enrique Mas, pretty much just a clone, a Spanish clone of Miguel Angel Lopez, more or less. Can't time trial. Did finish 5th in the Tour. Sorry, 5th in the Vuelta, and then in the Tour he finished 5th as well. Slightly better TT here, 9th to be fair, so not absolutely horrendous. So I think he's all right at TTing, but he's not definitely outrageous at all, so I can't expect him to go crazy good. One man who I think no one seems to have spoke about, but I think is going to go really well, is Julien Alaphilippe. Now you might say, why? Because, you know, he's not that good. I think he's good at time trialing. Okay, he DNS'd in the Tour de Suisse, which is slightly useless, but he did finish second on this TT, which obviously was upper climb, so you might say, okay, not too relevant. But he finished 5th on this flat TT, and he only lost 19 seconds to Stefan Kung. Okay, it's a 12-minute TT, and Alaphilippe is good at his punchy efforts, but the boy's a good time trialist, and I genuinely think he's actually going to do really well, and would not be surprised if he gets on the podium at all. Obviously, his results this year are very good. One Flèche, second in Liège, you know, won a stage in Tirreno. Probably hasn't been his most vintage season you've ever seen, but I think this Tour he can really do well, and I'm super excited to see what he does. Obviously, last year in the Tour, he didn't really go for GC, did win a stage early on, but the year before, we all know what happened in the Tour. He managed to finish 5th, but was leading it for a long way. So I really think Alaphilippe is going to be a big favourite. Now we come to Rigoberto Urán. Now he, I think, is a quite a boring GC rider. He never really attacks very much. He just sort of rides. However, this isn't a bad tactic because realistically, most people ride like idiots when it's GC. All you have to do is just follow people, and then unless you're the strongest, you never attack. And he knows he's not the strongest, so he does ride quite well. He came second in the Tour de Suisse, won the TT there. I think he could be decent. Okay, the first ATT wasn't great, but I still think Urán's going to be out, going to do a lot better than most people think he will. Probably a top five, definitely could happen. Now we've got the reigning Tour de France champion, Tadej Pogačar. Obviously, probably is the favourite, not going to lie, to win it. His form has been good. He battered everyone in Slovenia, but to be honest, it wasn't that strong of a field in Slovenia. There was no one really that good. So I wouldn't read too much into Slovenia. Him not winning the national championships, also probably just getting some mates, didn't he? I think if he wanted to win them, he would have done. The individual TT was a bit odd, but I think maybe he was just a bit tired or something, or a bit hot, people said. Won Liège. The only thing I'd say with Pogačar, he hasn't really done much stage racing, like proper stage racing recently. Like, he's always done Slovenia, but he had a good 2 months off, I guess, when he was just training and then did just Slovenia. So maybe he might come in a little bit undercooked. But to be honest, Pogačar is like one of the best time trialists in the world. He's one of the best climbers in the world, and he's got a punchy, he's just punchy, and he doesn't get tired in the third week. So to be honest, like, he's obviously going to be my favorite, I think. I can't really see past him. The only thing is, his team isn't great. It is getting better and better. Like, they've got Micah this year and a couple others who look all right. Brandon McNulty, I rate. He's pretty good. But that could be the only real downside. Primož Roglič, well, I'm not really a fan of him. I think he's a bit boring. And I don't know, just bad vibes about him. But anyway, that shouldn't really prejudice me. He is probably going to do well. He's just gone for training, and I think he likes to train. I reckon he just goes out, looks at those numbers, and just loves it and doesn't really care about racing, because then he doesn't have to crash. In terms of, like, numbers and stuff, like, he'll be there. The thing is, can he stay on a bike for 3 weeks? I don't think so. I think he's got significantly worse at bike handling recently. He obviously won a stage in the Tour in 18, where he attacked on the downhill. However, after the crash in the Giro 2019, he really has gone worse and worse at descending. He crashed a lot in Paris-Nice on this last stage and just looked all out of shapes. Obviously, Basque Country, he then came back and had an absolutely outrageous W, but that was, what, 2 months ago? So not sure how much you can read into that, the form there. And then he had a decent Ardennes campaign, but nothing unbelievable for his standards. So I think he's definitely going to be up there, probably second or third, unless he crashes, which is a very high probability, or his team just messes up, because his team generally have no idea what's going on. They seem quite useless and often don't really understand how race is going to finish. Like, on this stage here where he finished second, like, it was so weird that they were like, he attacked so early into the finish, and Pogacar knew the finish way better than him, so it's like they just didn't recon it properly or didn't tell him what to do. So I think for that reason alone, I think it's gonna be hard for him to win. Now we've got Richard Carapaz. I'm a big fan of Carapaz. He just attacks, no messing around. Obviously, he's got a massive Achilles heel, which is his time trialing. He's got better and better since he's joined Ineos. However, he's still not really very good at time trialing, and that is going to be a big issue for him, because I can't see how he's going to come back. Now, I have missed some of the other Ineos lot, which was Thomas and Port, and I think they could actually do something together, because Thomas and Port both been time trialing pretty well recently, both look similar form. Port, if anything, has looked the strongest. I think with a Trident like them, they could do a Movistar, like actually pull it off, unlike Movistar, launching people left, right, and center, and they will have the strongest team, and maybe they can do something. I still think it's a long shot. I'm not sure Carapaz can win. He can definitely get on the podium if he has a good, like, solid TTs for him, and then just can attack, because in the mountains he has shown he can bin Roglic. I mean, Roglic in 2019 Giro, he had over a barrel. So potentially he could do it again. I'm not so sure about G and Port. Maybe, but both of them do really like crashing. So that is not ideal. Now, if we're going to go on to the Tour, we'll just have a look at the start list, because there's probably a couple of people who you said, hang on a minute, you've missed some people here. Well, I don't really see any of these Bahrain lot. Pello Bilbao could do all right. Good TT lad, but after doing the Giro, I think it's going to be really tough. Valverde's similar. Marc Soler, just nightmare. Higuita, I'm not sure he's going for GC, so we've ignored him. Louis Meintjes, he was good in 2017 and has got significantly worse from then, which is a shame. David Gaudu can't time trial, so there's just no point including him. I hope he goes for stages, because if he goes for GC, he's going to be very disappointed. Warren Barguil and Nairo Man both can't time trial, so there's just no point even thinking about it. Like, I don't know what they're going to expect. Like, on a 60k course of time trials, like, Nairo Man will lose maybe 4 minutes or more, so I just don't really know what's going to happen. And then these teams don't really have anyone who's going for the GC. Maybe Pellator, but there's no real point. His team, he's all right at time trialing, but his team probably doesn't spend enough money on time trialing, and he's just going to lose time. For Quickstep, that's about it. And then no one else really. Ben O'Connor, I like Ben O'Connor a lot, and he's all right at time trialing. He'll probably get a top 10, but I can't see him really challenging for the W. And for Bike Exchange, Chavez cannot time trial. Yates isn't going for GC, and Lucas Hamilton is, but again, he can't really time trial. So in conclusion of this video, you might think this has been a complete waste of time. Why have you watched me ramble on about GC contenders? Well, the point is this. Ultimately, in this Tour de France, the only thing that matters is the time trialing, because the mountain finishes are decent, but they're quite disappointing. There's a lot of, like, there's like the Vontu stage where they finish on a descent. There's a lot of things where I just don't think anything's going to happen. It's going to be suffocated. The Tour's always boring. You just have to remember that. It's not like the Giro where things can happen left, right, and center. People attack on downhills when it's snowing, like Bernal does, because why not? in the Tour, it's all more calculated. You never get any excitement, as much excitement as you do in other races. So it's all a bit sterile, and you just think, if I'm like Pogacar, all I need to do is just whack the TTs well, and jobs are good in defending the mountains. And it's the same with Roglic, and I can't really see many other people really disrupting them too, apart from potentially Ineos, if they just throw everything at it and just have chaos from kilometer zero on the first stage. But apart from that, I think it's going to be one of the Slovenian lot winning. But yeah, so leave me your thoughts obviously below. Who do you think is going to win? Who's going to crack? Who's going to do outrageously well, who I haven't even mentioned? That is the question. So anyway, cheers for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.